Good morning, everyone. Today, my topic is actually career success from good to great. Before we start on today's session, actually, I just want to do a very quick recap of what I shared in the last two sessions. The first time, actually, I shared about value and mission in life. And we spoke about the meaning of life. And the meaning, actually, of life is actually it's in our hands. It's in our own hands. Life itself has no meaning, but it's actually what we do in our life that gives it a meaning. And it's not the end. It's not the end result that actually determines the meaning of our life, but it's actually the journey that actually kind of determine the meaning of life. And how was the journey kind of write down the meaning for you? Now, the second session, actually, I talk about you being the captain of your life. You being the captain of your own ship. And being a captain, you need to be always focused on the direction and not just on your goals. Your goals are actually just your benchmark and your milestone, but your direction is what you should be focusing on. In life, we always get this course from our direction. We always get distracted. We get blown away from our course. But sometimes being this course, we just need to make some adjustments. We can't control the wind, but we can control our sail. And by adjusting to our sail, sometimes it will push us faster towards our final direction that we want to head towards. So stand firm, be positive with our direction, and nothing can blow you away. So today I'm going to share more with you about how to just go from good to great. Why is this so important? Because now we are being disrupted. Every one of us is being disrupted. So this is actually the best time for us to rethink about ourselves, to reinvent ourselves and think it through. Now, maybe just being good is not good enough. Okay. Now, of course, this idea came from this very famous book called Good to Great by Jim Collins. He wrote two very, very good books. Okay. The first one was Good to Great and the other one is Built to Last. Anyway, today, actually, I just picked up some key terms, key ideas from his book, and I'd like to share with all of you. His book actually started with a very, very interesting quote. It says that good is the enemy of great. Now, what does it mean? In fact, good is the enemy of great, and that's why there's so little things that is actually great. Because a lot of us, and I have actually shared with you all before, that a lot of, human beings are actually, by nature, seeking for comfort. You know, we work so hard, we work for the money, we work for the freedom very much. We are all seeking for the comfort. So a lot of times when we reach the comfort, we just refuse to move more. You know, we're just dwelling over the comfort. And so when we feel that it's good enough, we stop moving ourselves. And so we settle for good and not moving towards great. Okay, now very quick intro about myself. I'm Roger. I graduated from America. I came back to Malaysia since 1996. In year 2000, I accidentally started my first company, which is actually a promotion agency. At my peak, actually, I have more than 40 over full-time staff. And every year, I recruit and train more than 2,000 temporary staffs and promoters. I personally pick them and I train them all by myself. Now, fast forward to today, I'm still COVID-free. Yay! I hope all of you are as well. I'm actually a retired consultant and trainer. I've been doing a lot of this training and talking since 5 years ago. But again, because of this COVID virus, because of this MCO, I'm also reinventing myself. I got to get out from my shell again. I got to get out from my comfort zone and do something that I haven't done it myself as well. Since last week, I actually did my first own Facebook Live. And I've been hosting my own show now. Every Friday afternoon, I have my own show, okay? And I'll bring people onto my show and interview them and talk to them about their business and how they're coping with MCO and how they intend to challenge themselves to their business. Well, I'm actually involved in all kinds of businesses and I've written three books. And very fortunately, my last two books, The Employee Ownership, in 2018, I won the Golden Pen Award. Now, these are actually pleasant surprises that I didn't expect. Anyway, if However, these books are no longer available in the bookstores. If any one of you is interested, I'm more than happy to share them with you. I call them the best remedy for a sleepless night. If you're having difficulty sleeping, this is the most organic way to fall asleep, okay? Now, this is just joke aside, all right? You can't find these books anymore in the bookstores. The only way is to get in touch with me. I'll be more than happy to send them a copies to you after the MCO. So in the previous two sessions, I already have collected a few names, and I will send them to send the books to them. Okay, now let's get on to the topic. Now, why want to be great? You know, so of course I understand a lot of you think that being good is good enough. You know, why want to be great? Now I tell you why you want to be great, because being great is indispensable. And what do I mean by indispensable? Now, indispensable also means that your immune system, your immunity is going to be so strong that nothing is going to blow you off, okay? If you are being great, I tell you, COVID virus is not going to attack you, okay? And what do I mean by that? Your job will be secure. Your business will be secure. You will become indispensable. Your clients cannot live without you, okay? And you will continue to live strong because you are great, all right? Do you want to be shocked by a crisis like this again? Do you want to be bitten? Do you want to be blown away from your course again? No, you don't want. And why? Because you want to be great, and you will be so strong, you'll be firm with your direction, and you'll be able to stay on course. Okay, that's why good is just not good enough, because life is full of surprises. Life will always just keep throwing us all kinds of curveballs, and we just have to try to hit them, right? So we need to continue to move ourselves to become great so that we become so strong immunity, okay? Now, great also means that we are irreplaceable. I will show you a few examples later, but before I show you those good examples, let's put it this way. When I say about this, a lot of companies, when their staffs leave, a lot of times the bosses will say, oh, no worries. You know, nobody is indispensable. Nobody is irreplaceable. No problem. You know, I'll just hire another person. Yeah, that's, I can tell you that 90% is true, you know. But the other honestly, the bosses actually just say that to comfort themselves, because it's painful. It's painful to lose a great player, you know. And what is a great player compared to just a good player? A good employee, yeah, you can actually easily replace them. But a really great one, I tell you, the company is not going to be able to replace them. Later, I'll show you an example. Now, greatness is what you get to own, okay, for a very, very long time. What do I mean by that? Now, whatever greatness that you are doing, if you're working for someone, don't, you know, the last thing ever you think about is whatever you achieve in the company, you think the company is going to snatch it away from you? No way. Whatever you achieve, if today you work for the company as a salesperson and you are the greatest salesperson ever in the company, if you were to leave the company, I tell you, it's a big, big loss to the company, because they have just lost maybe a few millions of business because you have left the company. You think they can overnight find someone to replace you? I don't think so, okay? Now, maybe sales is easy to point as an example, but imagine if you are the super admin person, you take care of everything in the office, you are the best ever, okay, admin person. If you're gonna leave, do you think the company can easily find someone to replace you? I doubt so. And this greatness is something that you get to keep, because when you grow old and you can tell your grandchildren, you know, in year 2020, when the country, the whole world was suffering with COVID, you know, grandson, I actually was the best ever in my company. You know, I did this, I did that. You'll be proud to talk about it. You will be a legend in your company, your ex-company. You'll be a legend to your family. You'll be a legend to your grandchildren, your great-grandchildren, and your descendants. You will be probably a story that they'll continue to talk about, okay? Trust me, okay? It will happen. I can show you a few examples of who are they. So what's being great? Now, this is where I'm going to show you the example. I'm sure all of you know LeBron James, right? A very, very great basketball player, okay? Now, is he great? He's pretty great. He won 3 NBA rings, okay? Now, there's only very, very few NBA players who have won more than 3 NBA rings or championship rings. Now, the other person, unfortunately, Kobe Bryant passed away early this year. Anybody know how many NBA rings does he have? He has 5 NBA rings, okay? Now, this is really, really outstanding, because there's only one other player in NBA that has more than him, and that is Michael Jordan. He has 6 of them, okay? Now, why are they so great? Now, How are they different from other NBA players? You know, to become a professional basketball player, you need to be really good, really, really good. You know, it's thousands of people in America who wish, dreams to be a player in NBA. Okay, but these people not only get recruited into an NBA team, but they have won multiple rings for the teams that they play for. Going back to LeBron James, he won three. Two of them is with Miami Heat. One of them is with Cavaliers, Cleveland Cavaliers. So when he changed team, he brought the team to a championship team, okay? He didn't just go in there as a player, but he brought the whole team up to the higher level. He brought the whole team up to another level. He brought the whole team up to a championship level, okay? And Kobe Bryant, he has been playing for Lakers, LA Lakers for his whole career, but he won it with two main so-called sidekick, okay? He played it with Shaquille O'Neal and he won three NBA rings with him, and he played with Paul Gasol and he won two NBA rings with him, okay? And he is the driver. If he didn't play for the team, LA Lakers will never ever win another NBA ring, okay? Now, Michael Jordan, he played his whole life with Chicago Bulls as well. What happened to Chicago Bulls ever since Michael Jordan left Chicago? They never even come close to another NBA rings, okay? That's what a great player is about, because they cannot be replaceable. They cannot be dispensable because they are the soul of the team, you know, and they are the best ever. Do they own the team? They don't own the team, but do they own their career? Absolutely, they own the career. They own the greatness. They own the greatness. You know, they brought their greatness further than the team. They brought the greatness further than their career, okay? And people are still talking about them, and they have brands, they have products that is selling off the NBA game, okay? So how to be great? Now I'm going to tell you how to be great. Number one, IQ brings you where you should be. Now, we study, we went through universities, we get our education, we get all our knowledge to get a good job, right? Or you get to start your business. But IQ can only get you where you should be, okay? But it is actually your EQ that brings you beyond where you are now, okay? You can get into a company, but you want to climb the ladder, you must really improve in your EQ. You started a business, you have some clients, but you want to manage the relationship, you want to grow the business, you need a little bit more EQ to it. You know, it's just like climbing, hiking, going for climb a mountain, you know? It takes a lot more internal strength, you know, for you to actually push yourself. It's more insight than just the skills that you have. You want to win a game, it's not just the skills and the ability that you have, but it's actually the mind game, okay? The mind game. You want to be great, you must improve your mind, okay? So, but I must give you a warning, very, very important warning. This is one warning that I want everyone, whatever that is in mental, the more you think about it, the more it grows, okay? You have to remember this. Now, just bear with me. Do this test, you know? Imagine something that you feel very happy about. The more you think about this happy incident, do you feel happier? On another case, if something that you feel sad about, the more you think about, don't you feel more sad? Okay, anything that is mental, it will stay with you and it will grow with you, okay? The same goes for depression, okay? If you feel lousy now, trust me, distract yourself, because the more you're going to think about it, the more it's going to stay around and it's going to eat into you like cancer, okay? It will eat into you until you totally crash, okay? Distract yourself with happy moments. Distract yourself with positive things. That's why I always say motivation is like vitamins to our brain, vitamins to our energy. Every day you must have it. Every day you must listen to it. Every day you must think, you just can't have enough of it, because that is going to keep you strong and keep you moving, okay? Now, that's why it's important to feed your brain with the right nutrients. Are you hanging out with the right people? Are you listening to the right thing? Are you talking to the right people? Are you reading the right stuff? Are you hanging out with the right people? Okay, are you doing the right thing? Okay, so now, and so when you have all those things, be disciplined. Discipline says everything. Do you think every Olympic gold winners win it by luck? Do you think they win it because, you know, they just put in some effort, you know, every day they train for 1 hour and then, oh yeah, they're going to win the gold medal, no problem.
I don't think so. They spend 8 hours, they spend 10 hours, they spend 12 hours every day, day in, day out. It's full of discipline and commitment and sacrifices. They don't get to spend time with their friends, but they are so focused. They are so disciplined. They know what they want to do. Now, how to be great in the book, Good to Great? There are three things. You need to have the right person, okay? And then you need to have the disciplined thoughts and you need to have the disciplined action, you know? And he emphasized that you need to be have this three discipline: disciplined person, disciplined thoughts, and disciplined action. Discipline is so important for you to be great, because without discipline, you're just going to give up. Without the discipline, you're just not going to stand firm with your mindset. You're just not going to carry along. You're just not going to complete the race. You're just not going to complete the mountain hiking, you know. So you just got to be very disciplined and stay focused and be very strong in your mind, okay? Now, give you a few more quotes, okay? Ask me to play, I will play. Ask me to shoot, I will shoot. Ask me to pass, I will pass. Ask me to steal, block out, sacrifice, lead, dominate, anything. But it's not just what you ask of me. It's what I ask of myself. Now, greatness is not something that other people can ask you to do. Greatness is not something that other people can motivate you to do. Greatness has to come from within. Greatness has to be something that you want to have. Greatness has to be something that you desire to have and you stay focused with it. It's something that you will not quit until you achieve it. It's something that you really want it. It's not something that you just talk about it, okay? Now, my brain. This is Kobe Bryant's quote. My brain, it cannot process failure. It will not process failure. Because if I sit there and have to face myself and tell myself that you are a failure, I think that's almost worse than death. Unfortunately, he has died. Okay, sad to say. Now, resilience and perseverance. Okay, we just have to stick on with it and just continue trying. Look at Michael Jordan. I've missed more than 9,000 shots in my career. I've lost almost 300 games. 26 times I've been trusted to take the game-winning shot and missed, okay? I've over and over and over again in my life, and that is why I succeed, okay? Look at how many times Michael Jordan actually tried and he failed, but he came out as the greatest player in NBA, all right? I have nothing in common with lazy people who blame others for their lack of success. Great things come from hard work and perseverance. No excuses. Now, are you ready for greatness? Is that something that you want to be? Is that something that you want to do? Or you want to be able to be blown away by some crisis again in life? Or are you going to be strong from now on? Now, I'm just going to give you one last strategy for the road, okay? Now, already, Max have told you, this is going to be our last English session. This strategy is from Blue Ocean Strategy, okay? It's from another great book, okay? I have very short time to share with you, but I think this is fantastic. While you're doing this reinvention, while you're trying to rethink about your life and you're trying to replan about your career, rethink about your business, how are you going to move forward from here, right? We are all doing that. Same as my own business. I go through that. I do this re-strategizing, okay? So this is a very, very good so-called methodology in Blue Ocean Strategy. And that is what we call ERRC, okay? ERRC, very quickly, I'm just going to go through with you. Eliminate. Think about it. This is kind of like SWOT analysis kind of thing, okay? So determine on the new value that you want to have. What is the new achievement that you want to have? And in order to achieve the new value and the new achievement, you probably got to eliminate some of the things that you have been doing and have been doing it for too long. And then probably it should be something that you should not be doing, because the more you do it, it's going to become an obstacle, is going to slow you down. It's just not going to add value to you. It's just not going to make you great, okay? So think about it. Make a list of it. Things that you should eliminate. Same goes for things that you should reduce. Maybe there's certain things that you can't give up away, but then it's just taken up too much of your time. You sure probably shouldn't do too much of it, okay? You can keep them, but you don't want to spend too much time of it, so you reduce them. On the other hand, you should also raise or increase certain things that you're doing. You may want to do more of it because that's going to add more value to you. You want to think about that. And certain things that you have never done before, you want to start doing them. You want to create it, okay? You want to increase it. So it comes to a chart like that. It's like a four quadrant thing. Make a list out of the four grids, okay? The four quadrant. Make a list out of them. What are the things that you are currently doing that you would like to reduce, you would like to eliminate, you don't want to do anymore, okay? And what are the things that you want to increase the frequency, you want to do more of it, or there are things that you have never done before and you want to do more of it so that you can bring more values to your life, so that you can be the next greatest person ever, okay? In whatever that you do, okay? You'll be the greatest and the best in whatever that you do, okay? So you should write this down on a piece of paper and make a vouch to yourself, okay? This is exactly what I'm going to do after the COVID-19, after the MCO, or even start from today, right now. What can you do now, okay? Don't wait for things to happen. You're going to do it now, okay? So this is my exercise to you. I'm going to leave you with these gems before I complete my today's talk. Okay, the ball is now in your hands and the court belongs to you. Okay, thank you and good luck to every one of you. Thank you very much.